Everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Travel Discoveries. Today's topic, we will discuss about the Metro Manila Travel Advisory and guidelines for COVID-19 vaccine protocols for those foreigners and travelers that wanted to travel in the Philippines, local and international. So we will discuss about the quarantine category, movement and guidelines, and also the list of RT-PCR labs available and emergency contacts, list of LGUs open for tourism and international travelers and local domestic travelers. Before we start our discussion, I wanna shout out my subscribers, to the new subscribers and all my subscribers, especially to Miss Angela Carla Paco, Jaber DC, and Extreme Fire Arts. Thank you for watching and thank you for the comments. So for those who wanted to comment, please comment down below in my description box and I will read all your comments as soon as, okay? Don't be shy to participate. Please stick around until at the end of this video so that you are fully understand the updates for Metro Manila Travel Advisory and the guidelines for COVID-19 vaccines protocols. So let us further ado, let's start. Metro Manila Travel Advisory and Guidelines for COVID-19 Vaccine Protocols. Here's what you need to know. Quarantine category. Metro Manila will remain under Alert Level 3 until January 31, 2022. Movement and Guidelines. Travel within and between zones are allowed but subject to restrictions of respective local government units or LGUs. MICE activities and tourist attractions are allowed to operate 50% capacity for outdoor venues and 30% capacity for indoor venues. As per Metropolitan Manila Development Authority or MMDA Resolution Number 22-01, individuals who are not inoculated with the attractions are allowed to operate 50% capacity outdoor venues and 30% capacity for indoor venues. As per Metropolitan Manila Development Authority or MMDA Resolution Number 22-01, individuals who are not inoculated with the COVID-19 vaccine shall remain in their residences at all times except for the procurement essential goods and services. Entry rules for resources. Entry rules for returnees or foreign nationals. Refer to IATF Resolution Number 154-C, Country/Territory Classification for green, yellow, and red countries. Refer to IATF Resolution Number 157-B. For more details. List of RT-PCR labs available. Among Rodriguez Memorial Medical Center, telephone number 8941-0342. Asian Hospital and Medical Center, telephone number 02-8771-9000. Chinese General Hospital 02, area code 02-8711-4141. Ito si Kerr Molecular Diagnostics Laboratory, area code 02-8256-4681. Dr. Jose N. Rodriguez Memorial Hospital and Sanitarium, Gene Expert 02-8294-2571. Or 8294-2573. Lung Cancer of the Philippines or LCP. Telephone number 89246101. Makati Medical Center or HB 02-8888-8999. Philippines Genome Center UP Diliman, NHB. Telephone number 8981-8500, local 4713. Philippines Red Cross National Blood Center 02-8790-2300, local 931-932-935. Philippines Red Cross Port Area 02-8527-0861. For the emergency contacts, 1 Hospital Command Center 632-8865-0500 or 632-915-77-7777 or 632-919-977-33333. Metropolitan Metro Development Authority or MMDA Hotline 136. Philippines Red Cross Hotline 1158. Makati Medical Center 632-8651-7800, local 1149 or 1150. DOH COVID-19 line 632-894-26843. List of LGUs open for tourism: Manila, Intramuros, Baguio City, Batangas Province, Cebu Province, Bohol Province, Albay Province, Baler, Bataan Province, Benguet Province, Camarines Norte Province, Camarines Sur Province, Cavite Province, Clark Prison Pampanga, Ilocos Norte Province, Boracay Islands, and Puerto Princesa Province. Is the Philippines open for tourism? The answer is no. Currently, only Balikbayans who are nationals of non-visa required countries, former Filipinos, those traveling with a Filipino or former Filipino spouse or parent, and foreigners with valid and existing visas are allowed to enter the Philippines. For domestic travelers, answer is yes. To reopen destinations only and with restrictions, traveling within the Philippines is allowed for domestic tourists, but it is limited to select destinations and with restrictions. Some destinations only allow leisure travel for local residents. Can foreigners travel to the Philippines? The answer is no. Executive order allowing fully vaccinated nationals of non-visa required countries in the green list of the country has been temporarily suspended. Are foreigners allowed to enter the Philippines now? Their answer is no. For countries that are under the green and yellow list, Only the following foreigners are allowed to enter to the Philippines, such as balikbayans under RE 6768. This is limited to nationals from non-visa required countries. Under EO 408 and former Filipinos and those traveling with a Filipino or former Filipino spouse or parent. Foreign nationals with valid and existing visas, those that 9A visa required to present an entry exception document from the country's foreign post abroad. Is it safe to travel in the Philippines now? The answer is, in terms of health, the national government and local government units have safety guidelines in place to lessen the spread of COVID-19. This includes the wearing of face masks, social distancing, and the requirement of a negative COVID test result or a vaccination card or certificate when crossing local borders. Following these rules will reduce your chances of contracting the disease. Tourist spots are generally safe, but it's always best to be alert. Make sure all your belongings are secure and be cautious when interacting with strangers. What are the requirements for foreigners required to present to enter the Philippines? The answer is, to travel to the Philippines without a visa is restricted. Below are the following requirements for foreigners traveling to the Philippines. First, so guys, this is only those allowed to travel in the Philippines. First is balikbayan. Must come from a non-visa required country under EO 408. Those traveling with their Filipino spouses and parents need to provide proof of filiation. Second, foreign nationals with valid and existing visas, valid visa and ECR1- card. Those with a 9A visa are required to present an entry exception document from the country's foreign post abroad. All inbound travelers are also required to undergo quarantine at an accredited quarantine hotel or facility. The length of the quarantine depends on which classification their origin of country is in and the traveler's vaccination status. But each traveler must present a confirmed booking as part of the requirements for entry. Green-list countries, yellow-list countries, and countries under Philippines travel and countries under Philippines travel ban. The IETF has adopted three classifications for countries and territories. So the first one is green countries. Those that are classified as having a low risk of COVID-19 infections. Second, yellow countries. Those that are classified as having a moderate risk of for COVID-19 infections. And the third is the red countries. Those that are classified as having a high risk for COVID-19 infections. Countries under the green list. Those coming from green countries and are fully vaccinated are exempted from undergoing quarantine upon arrival in the Philippines. They need to present a negative RT-PCR test result taken 48 hours prior to their departure from the country of origin. They must also self-monitor for any symptoms until the seventh day from their arrival. While the unvaccinated or partially vaccinated travelers from green-list countries need to present a negative RT-PCR test result taking 48 hours prior to their departure from the country of origin. They are also need to undergo quarantine in a government-approved facility upon arrival in the Philippines. They need to take an RT-PCR test on the fifth day and will be released once they get a negative result. They must also self-monitor for any symptoms until the 14th day from the arrival. The testing and quarantine protocols of minors shall follow that of the parent or guardian traveling with them, regardless of minors' vaccination status, country of origin. Unless symptomatic, minors aged 3 years and below are not required to present a negative RT-PCR test result. There are 32 countries and territories on the green list effective January 16 to January 31, 2022. First, Bangladesh, Benin, Ghana, Guinea, Hong Kong, India, Indonesia, Japan, Kosovo, Kyrgyzstan, Montserrat, Morocco, Niger, Oman, Pakistan, Paraguay, Sabah, St. Bartholomew, Senegal, Sierra Leone, St. Eustatius, Taiwan, Timor-Leste, and Uganda. That is for the Green List countries. To check the updated list, visit the Bureau of Immigration website. Countries under the yellow list that are neither in the green or nor red list are considered part of the yellow list. To check the updated list, visit the Bureau of Immigration website. Coming from yellow list countries are fully vaccinated, need to present a negative RT-PCR test result taken within 48 hours prior to their departure from their country of origin. So guys, if you are comes from the yellow-green list, then you need to present a negative RT-PCR test result within 48 hours prior to the departure of your country of origin. Upon arrival, they need to undergo a 6-day quarantine in a government-approved facility. They need to have an RT-PCR test on their fifth day of quarantine and will be released once they get a negative result. Regardless of the result, they are required to undergo home quarantine until the 7th day from their arrival. Unvaccinated and partially vaccinated travelers from yellow list countries also need to present a negative RT-PCR test result taken within 48 hours prior to their departure in their country of origin. Upon arrival, they need to undergo 8 days of quarantine in a government-approved facility upon arrival in the Philippines to take an RT-PCR test on the 7th day and an additional 6 days at home quarantine after their facility-based quarantine. The testing and quarantine protocols of minors shall follow that of the parent or guardian traveling with them, regardless of the minor's vaccination status and country of origin. Unless symptomatic, minors aged of 3 years and below are not required to present a negative RT-PCR test result. For the countries under the red list, the Philippines travel ban to those coming from the countries included in the red list has been lifted. Those coming from red list countries and are fully vaccinated need to present a RT-PCR test result taken within 48 hours prior to the departure of the country of origin. Upon arrival, they need to undergo an 8-day quarantine in a government-approved facility, and they need to have an RT-PCR test on their 7th day of quarantine and will be released once they get a negative result. Regardless of the result, they are required to undergo home quarantine until the 14th day from their arrival. For the unvaccinated and partially vaccinated travelers from the red list countries, also need to present a negative RT-PCR test result taken within 48 hours prior to their departure in their country of origin. Upon arrival, they need to undergo 10 days of quarantine in government-approved facility. Upon arrival in the Philippines, they need to take an RT-PCR test on the 7th day and are required to undergo home quarantine until the 14th day from their arrival. The testing and quarantine protocols of minors shall follow that of the parent or guardian traveling with them, regardless of minors' vaccination status and country of origin. Unless symptomatic, minors aged 3 years and below are not required to present a negative RT-PCR test. There are 14 territories on the red list effective January 16 to January 31, 2022. First, Antigua and Barbuda, Aruba, Canada, Curacao, French Guiana, Iceland, Malta, Mayotte, Mozambique, Puerto Rico, Saudi Arabia, Somalia, Spain, and U.S. Virgin Islands. That is for the red list countries. Is an International Certificate of Vaccination or ICV required by the Bureau of Quarantine or BOQ to enter the Philippines? The answer is, an International Certificate of Vaccination Card or ICV is accepted as proof of a traveler's fully vaccinated status. But other documents may also be accepted in its place. Those includes a VaxCert PH, digital vaccination certificate, or a national or state digital certificate of the foreign government where they were vaccinated, which has accepted VaxCert PH under a reciprocal arrangement. How to get an ICV? ICVs are issued by the country where you got the vaccine. If you got your vaccine in the Philippines, you can get your ICV by booking an appointment via icv.boq.ph. It costs 300 pesos and 70 pesos for a convenience fee will also be charged. Alternatively, you can apply for a vaccination certificate via vaxcert.doh.gov.ph. To prove your fully vaccinated status when entering the Philippines. What to do upon arrival at Philippines Airport? After you land in the Philippines, you need to follow the guidelines set by the IATF. This includes wearing face masks and face shields, filing up a case investigation form or CIF, and using the Trace mobile apps for the complete requirements and procedures for its airport, traveler's vaccination status, they must quarantine at a government-approved facility for at least 6 days and continue their quarantine at home for at least 4 days. What to do during the stay at the quarantine hotel? From the airport, you need to go directly to your quarantine hotel. Wait for the confirmation of the schedule of your test. Should you exhibit symptoms before your scheduled test, you need to inform the hotel staff immediately so the medical officer can assess you. On the day of your test, present your passport and the other required documents. If your test results are negative, you will be released for home quarantine. However, if your test results are positive, you will be transferred to a hospital for treatment. During your stay at your quarantine hotel, you won't be allowed to leave your room. So make sure to pack your own entertainment and bring it along with you. Guide to the Philippines has Manila Hotel quarantine packages with airfare from US and Canada that come with free virtual guided tours and interactive activities like the Intramuros tour, Palawan tour, Cordillera tour, Filipino language class, Ibayan class, Kapampangan cooking class, and Juan Luna mystery game. For more details, please check this arrival guide. Airlines flying to the Philippines, Philippine Airlines. The flag carrier currently has flights from Australia, Canada, including Vancouver, to Manila, Hong Kong, Indonesia, Japan, Malaysia, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, Singapore, South Korea, Taiwan, Thailand, United Arab Emirates, United Kingdom, Vietnam, and the USA, including Los Angeles to Manila, San Francisco to Manila, Hawaii to Manila, and New York to Manila routes. Second is All Nippon Airways or ANA, the airline's flights from Japan. AirAsia, the airline has flights from China, Hong Kong, Malaysia, Singapore, South Korea, Taiwan, and Thailand. Asiana Airlines, the airline has flights from South Korea. Cebu Pacific, the airline has flights from Hong Kong, Japan, South Korea, Singapore, and United Arab Emirates. China Airlines, this airline has flights from Taiwan. Emirates, the airline has flights from United Arab Emirates. Etihad Airways, this airline has flights from United Arab Emirates only. Japan Airlines, this airline has flights from Japan and the USA. Jetstar, the airline has flights from Singapore. Korean Air, South Korea and USA. Malaysia Airlines, the airline has flights from Malaysia. Qatar Airways, the airline has flights from Qatar. Singapore Airlines, the airline has flights from Singapore. Thai Airways, airline has flights from Germany, India, Italy, Netherlands, Norway, Pakistan, Sweden, and Thailand. Turkish Airlines, the airline has flights from Turkey. Since accepted in the Philippines, there are currently 8 COVID vaccines which have emergency use authorization or ENA. From the Philippines Food and Drug Administration or FDA. Here is the list which have emergency use authorization or EUA. From the Philippines Food and Drug Administration or FDA. Here is the list. Pfizer, BioNTech, AstraZeneca, Sinovac, CoronaVac, Sputnik V, Johnson, Covaxin, Moderna, and Sinopharm. if you are vaccinated, can you travel without COVID test? The answer is yes. Fully vaccinated travel is available in the Philippines, but not for all destinations. Several destinations in the Philippines have opened to fully vaccinated tourists, exempting them from the requirement of obtaining a negative RT-PCR test result or rapid COVID test for travel. Here is the list of destinations fully vaccinated travelers may visit without having to undergo a COVID-19 test. Destinations in Luzon without RT-PCR test result for fully vaccinated: Albay, Baler, Bataan, Batangas, Benguet, Arenas Norte, Camarines Sur, Cavite, Clark, El Nido, Lago Occidental Mindoro, Nueva Ecija, Pampanga, Pangasinan, Puerto Galera, Subic Bay, Freeport area, Tagaytay, and Tarlac. Destinations in Visayas without RT-PCR test for fully vaccinated: Bacolod City, Bohol, Cebu, Dumaguete City, Eastern Samar, Guimaras, Leyte, Negros Occidental, Ormoc, Romblon, Sikihor, and Taklo. Destinations in Mindanao without RT-PCR test result for fully vaccinated: Bukidnon, Cotabato, Davao City, Davao de Oro, Davao del Norte, Davao del Sur, Davao Oriental, General Santos City, Misamis Occidental, Sarangani, Sultan Kudarat, Sambuanga, Sibugay. Will you be able to travel without COVID-19 vaccine? The answer is yes. Some destinations in the Philippines only require travelers to present a government-issued ID to enter, but others still have a negative RT-PCR test or antigen test result as a part of the requirements before you can board a domestic flight in the Philippines. Some destinations also require a mandatory quarantine for travelers, as well as negative test result after a number of days in the destination. So that's it only, guys, for the Manila travel guide. For the travelers who wanted to visit in the Philippines, have a requirement, guys. If you wanted to check all the details, just visit the website, the Philippines Immigration website. Okay. Guys, for those who have any questions, please comment down below in my description box and I will answer as soon as. For the watch time from subscribers, according to my analytics, my viewers that is not subscribed in my channel is 91.8%, while the subscribe is only 8.2%. So imagine, guys, if those 91.8% you subscribe, you have a big help my channel. So please consider to subscribe, okay? If you think that this content can help you and give you some ideas and information, please consider to subscribe. Select all and click that bell icon so that if I have a new upload videos, you'll be notified as soon as. And also share to your friends, like and give a thumbs up. And I guess that's it for today. See you in my next vlog. Stay safe, bless you all. Thank you for watching. Bye.